Welcome to part 9 of the video series on Spoken English Fluency 2.0. In this particular course, we are guaranteeing you that you can improve your spoken English and you can improve your spoken English fluency in just 21 days with the right tips, with the right tricks, with the right strategies and just little bit of practice of whatever we are trying to say. You can improve your spoken English fluency in just 21 days. Now today the topic that we're going to discuss today is basically how do you reduce your English syllabus by 93%. Just imagine if you had your syllabus reduced by 93%, you just require to study 7%, and once you are required to study only 7%, you will be happily motivated to study and you will reach your goal very, very fast. Isn't it true? So let us quickly move on and find out what is the strategy and how you can reduce your English language learning, spoken English and fluency syllabus by 93%. So just stay with me, and as I keep on telling you what are those strategies in which you can do it. Now economist Wilfred Pareto gave a beautiful law, the 80-20 rule. He said that if you focus on just the 20%, you'll be getting 80% of the results, focusing on the important 20%. So you need to understand as a student what is that 20% on which you should focus so that you get 80% of the returns. Now if you look at the engineers, if you look at the doctors, if you look at the UPSC toppers or toppers for any particular examination, you will find that they have mugged up the entire syllabus. They have completed the entire syllabus, but they have done it in a smart way. They have become very, very smart at understanding, at prioritizing what is important and leaving what is not important. They have gone and they have left a significant amount of concepts, a significant amount of chapters they have not studied by prioritizing. So you need to understand, to top in any particular exam, to top in life, to learn a skill quickly, you have to understand what are the things that you should be doing and what are the things that you should not be doing. Now in the earlier videos, if you have been watching all our earlier videos, we have been telling that if you have been focusing on grammar, you're just wasting time. For a beginner, grammar is not important. If you have been focusing on vocabulary, again, that is not important for a beginner. And if you have been focusing on doing grammar exercises, you have just been wasting your time. So, point is, as a smart student, you have to focus on the 20% that matters and leave the 80%. Leaving is very, very important. Most of the students commit this particular mistake. They keep on engaging with the 80% and wasting their time. So I am here to tell you what is that 20% that you need to be doing so that you can improve your English. Now, this is Dr. Albert Mehrabian's formula. Reducing your syllabus by 93%, I'll give you life proof towards the end of the video. Stay connected, keep watching, and I'll give you life proof of how this particular formula can be applied in your English language learning. Now, Dr. Albert Mehrabian gave a particular formula. He said that when we are communicating with another person, we are communicating through voice, tone, and body language, and words in that particular category comprise only 7%. We communicate more through our emotions. We communicate more through our body language, through our facial expressions, through the way our eyes close, drop, through the pitch of the voice. See, I just raised my voice now and I'm just speaking slowly now. So this comprises a major component when we are communicating with anybody. So when you're communicating in English with anybody, then you have to keep this particular rule in mind. And this is the rule that will help you reduce your syllabus by 93%. Because words are not important. Most of the times, words are not important. What you're saying is not important. Grammar is not important. What is more important is how you are communicating it. It is important how your voice is. It is important what is your body language. What is your facial expression. So these things matter a lot when we are communicating. Now let me give you an example. I'll give you a practical demonstration of this particular concept. Now imagine you have to appear for an interview, right? So you are just going to appear for an interview. Your resume, they have liked. Your resume did the job. You got the actual, your resume got shortlisted. Your candidature was shortlisted. They thought that you are the right person they can hire. So they call you for the interview. यू अपियर फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर इंटरव्यू एट द कंपनी प्रिमाइसेस. आप उस दिन कंपनी पे जाते हैं, यू आर इन योर बेस्ट फॉर्मल अटायर, यू हैव वॉर्न द बेस्ट क्लोथ्स, यू हैव mugged up all the tips, tricks and everything from YouTube channels, you have read good amount of books on interviews and interviewing, you have had some mock interviews also with some of your friends and with a coaching center. I mean, you're well prepared for the interview. Now your name is called and the receptionist asks you to move in. It's your turn now. You can go inside the particular room. You knock the door, you ask, may I come in the room? And then you walk in. You walk in to the interviews, you wish everybody good morning, good evening, or whatever the standard time of the day that is. You shake hands with them and you take your seat. Now, what is important is that till this particular time, you have not even uttered a single word from your mouth. You have just knocked the door, entered the particular interview room and just taken your seat after wishing them. But did you know that in that particular period, when you have not even started speaking, your interview is 80% complete. Yes, I'm repeating it. Your interview is 80% complete because words don't matter. People can judge you. People can understand what you are made up of, what is that you are going to say. They can judge your personality. They can judge your total candidature by the way you dress, by the way you express, by the way you smile, by the way you walk, that is also body language, the way you use your hands, body gestures. So all these things, basis of that, these interviewers have been interviewing people for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. It does not take them more than 30 seconds. Yes, 30 seconds to make a judgment about you, and most of the times, in 90% of the times, those judgments about you are correct. So what happened? You have not even spoken the words. Words, if you feel, are important. I'm just telling you, words are not that important. What you speak is not important. The way you express yourself through your body language, through your facial expressions, is important. Always know, emotions are greater than word. Now imagine a particular scenario. How the emotions keep on changing and how the meaning of that particular word or group of words, sentences will change according to various scenarios. In a normal mood, you would say, I told you to close the door. Angry mood, I told you to close the door. Question, I told you to close the door. Sad, I told you to please close the door. Happy, ha ha ha, I told you to close the door, but you have not closed it till now. So look at these particular scenarios. Normal mode, angry mode, questioning mode, sad mode. Most of the time, your face does the expression part. Your face created a different kind of a meaning for that particular sentence. The sentence remains the same, but how you are going to express it. The actors do it in the best possible way. Maybe I did not act it in a very proper way, but go and look at the actors. The same sentence can be said in 10 different ways with 10 different emotions, and it will have a different kind of a meaning. So what are words important? No, words are not important. Words are not important. Your emotions are important. And many of the times, if you are feeling the emotion from within, then you need not even do a class in acting. You can almost do all of the moods in that particular way, and people will be able to understand you. Now, that is a practical demonstration of an interview. In an interview, 38% of your interview is based on the quality of your voice. When you are interacting with somebody, 38% of that is based on the quality of your voice. In an interview, 50% is the way in which you dress and the way you walk inside the room, the confidence in your voice. Are your shoulders drooping like this, or are you walking straight, with your head back and chest out? Are you walking in that particular way? So confidence and your body language matters a lot, whereas words are just 7% of the entire story. So that is a unbelievable kind of a statistic, that 80% of the interview is over even before you have spoken a single word. I hope you would be having difficulties still. So let me give you one more experiment, and you can try this experiment on your own and come back to me in the comment section, in the feedback section, whether what I am saying is wrong or right. Now I'll give you an example from my own life. Let me tell you a small story I was young. It was the 1990s. It was 1985, 1990s. I was in class 7th, class 8th, and the newfound love at that point of time was the television which had entered into our homes. Now, compared to today's time where you have a lot of options, you have Netflix, you have Hotstar, you have so many various platforms which offer a lot of entertainment, you have YouTube, you have the internet, you have your own mobile, you have social media, there are so many options you can engage into. But for us at that point of time in the 1990s, we had the only one particular television box, and that too, we did not have multiple number of channels, we just had Doordarshan, one singular channel and one singular movie, two movies in a week and two songs episode in a week. Chitrahar we used to call them. Now that was an entertainment deficiency at that point of time for all of us. Now I remember Sunday afternoon they used to relay a particular movie, a regional movie. That movie could be in Kannada, in Telugu, in Tamil, in Marathi, in Bengali. At 1 p.m. every Sunday they used to relay, Doordarshan used to relay a particular movie in Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Marathi, Bengali, whichever language it was. Now, my relatives used to call me mad when I used to sit down and watch the entire 3-hour movie, 2.5-hour movie in a language which was not my own. My native language is Hindi, and English I was learning in an English medium school. But Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Marathi and Bengali, I was having no idea of. But do you think I understood that particular movie? And you would be, anybody would be assuming, because my family members also used to consider me mad. Ki ye pagal ho gaya hai, he is watching the entire series, he is watching the entire movie, 3 hours he is wasting, and he will not be able to understand anything about this particular. Why? Because it is in a different language. But let me tell you, that is not the scenario. Now, let me give you practical examples. What do you say to a person when you meet him for the first time? Nice to meet you. What would you say to a friend who helped you? When you're going on the road and somebody helped you, what would you say? You would say thank you. What would you say to a person when you have committed a mistake? I'm sorry, I will never do that again. Across cultures, you will find, across cultures, across languages, these notations remain the same. It will change, it will not change irrespective of which language you are using. Most of these things, if somebody has helped you, your face will show and you will say a thank you. In your own language definitely, but your face will also do a lot of saying. So words are not always important. Let me give you another scenario. If somebody is happy, if somebody is crying, if somebody is sad, if somebody is laughing, do you think language can compress it and convey that? Just by looking at the face, you can understand this person is happy. Just by looking at the face, you can find out, you know, the tears are coming up, somebody's crying. If somebody is laughing, you need not have any words to explain he's laughing. Emotions do not require words. The expression on the face of a man who becomes a father for the first time is irrespective of the language. So if I am watching a movie in Kannada and the actor is going to have a baby, he will feel happy. The first time he's becoming a father, he'll feel happy, and I'll be able to understand that even if the words do not support me, even if the words are not my language words, I'll be able to understand the story. And imagine the expression of the in the eyes of a boy when the girlfriend he proposes says yes to the proposal. So these things, imagine the expression of a mother when she tends to her young son and daughter. Mother is loving his son or her son or daughter, the expression over there. Girlfriend and boyfriend chemistry, the expression over there. So many of the times words do not matter a lot. So you have to understand that once you have started, you will be low on your words. You will not be having a good amount of vocabulary. You will not be having a good amount of phrases with you. You will not be having remembering a lot of sentences. You will be talking in small sentences at that point of time. But you have to understand that human beings do not require words always to communicate. We can understand words. The other person to whom you are speaking in your broken spoken English at beginning, he will be able to understand you in spite of you not using the best of best words, because most of the time, 93% of the times, we have proved it just backside, you know, that is the Dr. Albert Mehrabian's formula. It is used extensively in communication, that 93% of the times your words do not matter. Your words matter only in 7% of the times when you are communicating with someone one to one or in a group. Now imagine a kid talking. When a kid start talking, what does he do? Have you seen how the parents react when a kid makes small mistakes? When a kid makes small mistakes, the parents still understand. What do the parents do when a kid cannot speak a difficult word? They keep on helping him. Suppose the word is a longer word, refrigerator. So the parent, even if he will be saying it in a very different way, his own way, referee, he will be saying refrigerator. Maybe that this is how he will be saying it, but you have to understand the parent over there will still be able to understand, maybe by the expression of the particular child, or maybe by his pointing out to the refrigerator key, this is what I want, and the parent will be able to understand. What do the parents do when the kid's pronunciation, grammar is not proper? You have to understand that society will understand your communication, will understand your understand the meaning of whatever you are saying, irrespective whether you're using high frequency vocabulary words or bad grammar. They will understand your story even without good words being used. Now, what do you do when you have to make people understand? Look at the way I'm expressing it to you. I'm using a lot of hand gestures to interact with you. Why am I doing that? Because sometimes your hand gestures and the expression on your face will convey a particular message to the listener in a better way compared to the words that I'm speaking. The words that are coming out from my mouth will not be able to express it as properly as compared to the expressions. So you will find that whenever the concept is difficult, a teacher will use a lot of hand gestures, or he will use the board, or he will try to show you a picture so that you can understand that particular concept in a beautiful way. Why? Because the rule remains the same. It is, words are only 7%. Words matter only 7%. It is how you communicate it to them. What is the voice or tonality of your particular pitch? What is your body language? Are you standing straight? Are your shoulders drooping? All these things matter a lot. Words matter only 7%, and that was a very important tip, and this will help you reduce your English language communication skills syllabus by 93%. We have reduced your syllabus by 93%. Now you just need to focus on expressing, start speaking, and you will find people will still understand you in spite of your low vocabulary. If you have the doubt, go watch our video on vocabulary. We have told you vocabulary is absolutely irrelevant. It does not matter. So what matters is how you express things. Now, all these concepts that we are discussing in all these video series are coming from this particular book, which I have, which has taken me 5 years for compiling, How to Speak Fluent English and Impress People in 30 Days. These are simple, effective and practical secrets. These are the secrets which will help you speak English in a record time. And all these concepts are being borrowed from this particular book. If you want the book, the link is provided. You can go and download that particular book and read it. And I'm telling you, it will be worth your money spent. You are going to find out multiple number of solutions with multiple number of teachers. This is one book that will contains everything that you want to know regarding your English language fluency. It will improve your English fluency in a very, very short period of time. Now, if you have not liked our page, if you have not subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe, because the video notifications will be coming to you. You can watch the videos, staying home, staying safe, and learning a very, very important skill. Communication skills can improve your salary by as high as 80%, 70%. They can raise your salary by a very high margin. Most of the students across India are not able to speak fluent English, and they are losing their job because of it. Their communication is not good and they're losing their jobs because of it. So keep on watching these video series and go to the playlist section. Watch all the 8 videos that we have discussed. This was part 9 of the video. Watch all the 8 videos and you will be surprised. You'll be literally surprised by the amount of knowledge that I have to provide. And using those tips and tricks, I am telling you, I am guaranteeing you, I am assuring you, you will be able to speak English fluently. It was a pleasure interacting with you today. Thank you so much.